In this video, Dave shows you how he created this awesome portable arcade console using a Raspberry Pi 4, one of our laser machines, and some creative thinking.
In some previous videos, I had made some acrylic cases for our new Raspberry Pi computer. The plan all along for the Raspberry Pi was to use it in an arcade console. This is that build. I had already built a tabletop two-player version that had a built-in monitor. The only issue with that version was that it wasn't super portable. So the goal with this version was to make it more portable. I also wanted to be able to hook it up to different screens. This included not only larger TVs and monitors, but also my Android phone and an old Android tablet. After doing some quick designs in CorelDRAW, I started by cutting parts out of 1/4-inch MDF. This would form the box that would house the Raspberry Pi and all the wiring. I could have used 1/8-inch MDF, but I wanted this to be pretty sturdy and have a little weight to it. All the pieces were masked so that there wouldn't be any residue on the surface to make painting later easier. The top of the console that would house the buttons and joystick was made out of 1/8-inch black acrylic. I engraved some circles where the joystick screws would go so I wouldn't have to countersink them later. I would also be decorating this with some vinyl decals. I would also come to regret this color choice later. To protect the top of the console and to make it sturdier, I cut a 1/8-inch piece of clear acrylic. All the MDF pieces had their mask peeled off. If you look close, you can see how clean the pieces came out with the mask removed. We did a video about the benefits of using paper mask like this if you're interested. All the MDF pieces were then glued together using regular wood glue. To get ready for painting, I sealed just the sides of the console's box. I didn't bother with the top or bottom as they wouldn't be seen when it was assembled and in use. Since the console's acrylic top was black, the console box was also sprayed with black paint to match. Our in-house artist Sam designed a cool retro-looking sticker for the console. Since we don't have a vinyl sticker printer, we had to use our vinyl cutter to make this. Each color had to be cut out separately. After cutting all the colors, the excess vinyl had to be removed from in and around the cut designs. A clear application tape was then applied to the top to keep all the pieces together. The decal with instructions on how to exit out of games was applied to the front of the console box. The mask on the black acrylic was removed so that the stickers could be applied. It was at this point that I realized that black was a really stupid color choice. Even though it would be covered with a clear acrylic piece to protect it, it was still going to pick up every speck of dust and fingerprints while I worked on it. I added the stickers to the acrylic, but I had to do some of them in a particular order. Any designs that had multiple colors had to have the colors added bottom up. For example, the knight had three colors to him. The first bottom layer was orange, the second middle layer was yellow, and the final top layer was the red sticker on his shield. We'll be right back. I had purchased an arcade joystick and button set online. There's a number of listings for these on Amazon in different configurations and colors. The link to the one I purchased will be in the description below. Anyway, I had to add the labels to all the buttons, but they first had to be unassembled to get at the white base inside each. I just needed to push on the tabs holding the covers on, and they pop right out. I took a crappy box I had laying around and poked a bunch of holes in it. I pushed the white button bases into them and then applied the labels. The first two gave me some problems, but I realized the plastic still had some kind of mold release on them. A quick cleaning with Windex off camera made application a lot easier. I left a little sticker circle around each label so that I could better line up the labels with the buttons. I just didn't push down on it so it didn't transfer. Even if it did, it could have been easily peeled back off. The label orientation on the buttons didn't really matter, as they could be rotated when installed. After applying the labels, it was a simple matter to just snap everything back together. One thing to mention here, though. The buttons will all light up when they're on. The stickers will block the light coming through the white bases, so they will stand out nicely. Alternatively, you could just print up button labels on something like a white Avery label paper that you can get at your local office supply store. I'm sure they would still light up, but maybe not quite as bright since you'd be covering the entire surface. I next installed the joystick. I made sure to use screws that would sit flush with the surface when mounted. This way, the clear acrylic cover would fit over them. The paper mask was removed from the bottom and then from most of the top of the clear acrylic cover. The buttons were put in their places and the included locking rings were tightened. My plan was for the buttons to sandwich the two pieces of acrylic together. The wires that came with the button set were plugged in. Nothing complicated with this part. Both ends of the wires are the same, and they can only be plugged in one way. The joystick wire was a little different from the button wires, but that was obvious. The wires were then plugged into the included circuit board. I want to note that it doesn't matter where each wire gets plugged in, as long as they're plugged into a matching socket type. The system is USB, so each button will get assigned in the software later. I just plugged the wires into sockets to give me the most slack in the entire assembly. Before I went any further, I added some big squishy rubber furniture feet. I wanted something that would really keep this thing from sliding around. Then it was time to add all the wiring into the console box. I started with a set of USB ports. These are not 100% necessary, but if later you need to hook up a keyboard and mouse or want to use a console-specific game controller, you won't have to worry about ripping open the entire system to get at the Raspberry Pi's USB ports. I added a USB-C connector with a USB-C cord plugged in into the back of the box for the Raspberry Pi power supply. The connector was a nice tight fit.
That's what she said!
Just in case though, I added some hot glue around the edges to lock it in place. You could just have run holes out the back for the wires, but I wanted a more finished look. I then added an HDMI connector into the box. This was attached with screws and nuts. An HDMI to micro HDMI cable was then plugged in. It was time to get the Raspberry Pi 4 mounted into the box. I added some pieces of Velcro to the bottom and got it situated into an open area. All the wires were attached to the Raspberry Pi. The wires were a mess, so I cleaned them up off camera. I forgot to plug in the USB cable that goes to the joystick and buttons circuit board, so I did this now. I don't think I talked about this, but I made what I'm calling a screen support. I didn't even know if this would work, but I made this piece that can be sort of pulled out and swung up to hold a phone or tablet to use as a screen. I plan on hooking the console up to a TV or monitor, but I wanted to see if this would work. I should have attached this earlier, but I forgot. Anyway, I just used a long screw to attach the support and two nuts to secure it. I used the two nuts so that I could lock them against each other. I then ran some hot glue on the nuts to make sure they didn't loosen. All that was left to do was to plug in the button circuit board's USB cable and close it all up. I screwed the button board to the box using regular old drywall screws. What can I say, but I had them handy and they work well in MDF. The heads also sat slightly below the top of the acrylic so no one will get scratched by them. I also screwed on the joystick handle. I think it came out pretty good. Again, black acrylic was a huge mistake as it really shows up everything. I probably should have gone with a white theme. The video that follows will show the arcade console in action using three different screens. A monitor, then an old Android tablet, and finally my phone. Stay tuned at the end of this video where I'll share some additional tips and quirks of this setup. I want to leave you with some final thoughts and comments. The software on the Raspberry Pi is RetroPie. The game ROMs are available online if you look around. The entire process of getting the software and games on your Pi is more involved than I'm able to go into here. If you don't know how to do this already, I would suggest searching for RetroPie on YouTube, as there are a lot of good tutorial videos out there. The tablet and phone worked well, but had to be hooked up using an HDMI to USB converter and a free app called USB Camera Standard. Because of this, the sound didn't work. This is fixable though, but you would require that you get speakers or headphones to plug into the jack on the Raspberry Pi, and then change the sound setting in RetroPie. This isn't an issue with a TV or monitor that has speakers, as the sound comes through the HDMI connection. I made the arcade console for only a single player, because that's all the hardware I had left over from some previous builds. However, the shape and size of the console would definitely allow for a second joystick and buttons to be added. You would set up the second button circuit board exactly the same as the first. That's when it would matter where you plug each button in. When you first start up RetroPie, you'll have to go into the menu to configure your controller. Whether you have a one or two player setup, you only have to configure this once.
Thanks for watching. Let us know in the comments what you think and if you've ever thought about doing a project like this. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell to get notified of future projects. We have more projects coming soon. Stay tuned.